like the speed of sound. Feet can keep on the ground. Can't stay in one place. Moving like the speed of sound. We can keep on the ground. Can't stay in one place. Like a bullet train.
Namaste and La Catch, my family. We are up in the Sequoias training and gathering things for our creations. And we wanted to make a quick little video for you guys to remind you once again how important it is to get out into nature, how important it is to understand that nature has the innate ability to balance you and center you. When you're out in nature and you're climbing, something else happens inside your body, or you're running or hiking or exploring. Something innately older, your ancient self, remembers, even though you may not. It's important to understand that in this one incarnation is not more important than all of your incarnations combined. This is simply one flavor of experience in this timeline in which you chose to experience. And understanding that the balance and stewardship of this planet is for all human beings to understand and be responsible for.
Why inner peace? Why is inner peace so important? Ascension, you must understand, ascension is 99% emotional clearing. So as you clear more and more emotions and you're raising your vibration, you're becoming centered. Inner peace is a natural effect of that. But what's the benefit of it? We're talking about your DNA essentially. Modern science already knows that the more stressed out you are, the more your DNA tightens up like a knot, like a ball of yarn, tighter and tighter. What does that do to the vessel? It becomes diseased. Lifespan is shortened. The more you find inner peace, you unravel that ball of yarn, your DNA lifespan is lengthened, your true potential begins to activate, your true self begins to incarnate into the physical vessel. This is a process. Many of you are already on this process. Many of you are just now beginning to experience this process as humanity reaches this pivotal point in its evolution. It is beginning to remember its own organic technology. Technology that we as individuals have, and as a collective, we all create, co-create with each other. As each individual begins to remember these potentialities, it is expressed in different ways, depending on your experiences in this incarnation, for one, experiences in other incarnations. Your oversoul, as it is incarnating into the vessel, you will begin to remember other lifetimes. You're merging all of who you are into one stream. This is when you find inner peace, balance, and you anchor in your own Christed self. Christ consciousness begins to express through you. There are many of us going through this process now. We are much stronger when we are vibrating at this rate. You take one person that is vibrating at a coherent wavelength, and against 10,000 individuals that are vibrating like this on an individual discoherent wavelength, one of those individuals is much stronger at that coherency. So when you get individuals all around the planet that are vibrating now, let's say you got 144,000 of them vibrating at this coherency, it overrides the other 6-7 billion that are vibrating on individual discoherent wavelengths. Does that make sense? So, what is the importance of finding your balance, your inner peace? This is the topic. Ask yourself in meditation for more activation, for more DNA activation. Use mantras. When you feel other people that are attached to you from past timelines in this incarnation and others, use a mantra before that mental thought turns into emotional wavelength. Say a mantra. Balance, 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 balance. What you're actually doing is talking to these people in past. You're visiting, you're time traveling, past or future. But if that's, you're balancing that stream that you have attached to them. As you do that, you'll begin to balance all those that are attached to you in a much more effective way. So everything, remember, everything outside of you, you have to keep it outside of you. Anything affecting you is your choice. Your environment has the chance to affect you. That's why we come out into nature. We come out into nature to change the environment and connect to it. When you're in the city all the time, you are connecting to that environment. It is much harder to disconnect from that and find inner peace. This is important to visit natural nature. You know, climb mountains, go to a stream, put your feet in a stream. Whatever you have at your resources at your closest disposal, find what you have in your environment to reach out into nature and to tap in to Gaia. Real quick, how you charge from the sun, a technique that you can use in the beginning that we've tried out that's very effective is you blot out the sun with your left hand, put the sun right behind your middle finger, turn it 90 degrees, and where your palm is facing is the direction of the true sun, the brown dwarf behind it, and you can charge directly from there. Imagine, if you can't see it in the beginning, imagine a stream of light coming through your palm of your hand. It looks like a spiraling DNA pattern. It comes in, it hooks in around your chakras, and you're pulling in that light, that chi, from every chakra. You want to charge your body, your energy body, with light. As you do that, you raise your frequency. You can pull in, now you can pull in more chi, and your higher self has more a clearer stream to communicate with you with. Okay, when you start doing that, you'll start noticing an increase in synchronicities and higher self communication. This is a good way to connect with your higher self. I invite you guys to practice these techniques. We love hearing from you guys. If you have other techniques you want to share with us, please feel free to comment or leave us an email at support@unitethecollective.com. Namaste and Lakech.
As my brother stated, finding balance within that frequency is the key. In raising your vibration, all things are possible. In raising your vibration, you create a new reality around you. In lifting up the veil and in understanding what that truly means is that you are beginning to access your multidimensional aspects and ability sets which you are inherently born with. When activated, the causality of raising your frequency is being able to perceive on multiple dimensions simultaneously. Being one of the Christed, as my family members are across the planet, it's important to understand the purpose in which you serve. The purpose in which we all share is to raise the planet's vibration, raise the vibration of mass consciousness, and do it with the highest intent. As you're beginning to balance your night self with your light self, it's important to understand when these aspects are triggered throughout the day. For me personally, around 6:37 p.m. at night is when my nightshade, my night self, engages. What does that feel like? Well, it's a force. Both sides of this equation, light and dark, both have strengths. They also both have weaknesses. Okay? Here's an example for you. A gnarly warlord who only exists in the night side, right? has a very hard time giving a loving hug to their children, has a very hard time sharing compassion, has a very hard time respecting others that aren't in that specific frequency. How do you counter such an effect? Well, first you must understand it. You must understand that we are made up of multiple frequencies in this multiverse of understanding and experience, and then to not simply listen to simply one of them. It's a blending of consciousness. It's a blending of your aspects, and then existing in the highest intent, simply being, treat others like you would, how you would like to be treated, you know, with respect. Personally, how I get through it every single day in balancing my streams is around 6:30, 7 o'clock at night, I go to the gym. I work out very hard. For me personally, I like to lift heavy weight. You could do your cardio, whatever you'd like. You go for a walk. You could do sit-ups in your living room. Whatever it is, express that force in a productive manner. That's the key. A super being, right, which we're all beginning to get a taste of, is a being which has all of his or her aspects in alignment. So when the vessel moves, the entire stream moves. When there's something that needs to be done on this planet, all of me, all of we, adjusts that. To understand that you are simply the driver down here in 3D. You are the vessel. You are the 3D ground of your own individual stream, which is connected to all. In balancing your higher selves, it's important to understand that each of your higher selves has a different perspective on reality. In balancing multiple timelines within yourself, it's important to understand that maybe in 3D you're having a really bad day, but you might not understand that you're actually reenacting a very serious situation in a timeline of one of your higher selves. And in that moment, let's just say we're on a battlefield. Let's just say it's the night before the big battle. Let's just say you're all generals, and these decisions fall upon your shoulders about what happens in the morning. To have your vessel in this timeline balanced with the highest intent, that clarity is reflected through your entire stream. And that clarity might work towards, instead of battle, a negotiation, an alliance. Right? You yourself have now become the positive aspect of your stream in 3D. Four, maybe some of your aspects are on the light side. There's a cord of light coming straight from my sternum, going straight into the heavens. On my left, I have my light. On my right, I have my night. When interactions are going on in your stream, be another positive measure of balance for your stream, rather than reacting with emotion upon things that you might not be able to comprehend. There might be wake up from a dream or a simulation, and it might have a negative context to you. You might not feel too cool about it. To understand a new balancing your day, taking care of yourself, and acting with an open heart, you allow that magic to happen as the rest of your stream comes into alignment and a more productive, positive, efficient manner of reconciliation, vibratory balance, and clarity can be attained for not only you, but your entire stream. Always remembering that we are all one, and always knowing inside that love is which binds. Love is which binds all living things, all things. Not the vocabulary term where most people think, oh, I love you. Love. I speak of that which binds all things. If we all come from the same place, that brilliant golden white light which connects everything together, to understand that raw force of creation, that is love. That vocabulary term, used in the proper context, is accurate. I feel on our path right now, we are all doing very, very well. I'm very blessed to be in contact with all of you. Jason and I just wish to share our reflection in nature with you. We always like to take you guys with us when we have these moments of clarity, and to always truly understand and hear that we are all in this together. No matter what country you come from, what language you speak, we are all in this together, and together we will be successful. Namaste.